Today we are in St. John the Evangelist Church in St. John, Indiana. We're in the Northwest Quadrant near Chicago, Illinois. This is the fifth worship space of the parish, built about 10 years ago, and we're very blessed to be here in this new worship space with this beautiful organ that serves our liturgies. Music is integral to our liturgies here at the parish. There are so many different things that draw people to the church and help them worship God and help them pray. Music has always been of preeminent importance. St. Augustine himself said that to sing is to pray twice, and the organ helps us do that. So the organ is unchanging, and yet as our liturgies and our worship and our music have changed, the hybrid technology of this organ from Rodgers has allowed us to integrate that into our music and to serve it even better. We were not able, unfortunately, to afford a complete pipe organ. That's one of course the advantages to a hybrid organ, is to have the cost effectiveness of some ranks of pipes and yet to have that digitally augmented. So the enchamade trumpets were presented to us as a possible fifth phase that we could possibly fund for the building of the organ. And yet they were so magnificent when we saw the possibilities that we said, can we have the fifth phase first? So it was incorporated into the beginning. So we have that, plus many of the different technological MIDI sounds that can be brought into it. So it brings a completeness to the organ, and it gives us many capabilities that aid our worship. The beauty of this hybrid organ from Rodgers is that there is no audibly noticeable difference between the pipe organ sounds and the digital augmented sounds. I understand it's the technology that provides the variance of adjusting the digital to the actual temperature within the pipes, which provides that seamless integration and gives that completeness to the organ.
Hybrid organ is simply an instrument that combines some windblown pipes with some digital voices to make a complete organ. Combining both pipe and digital stops is an excellent idea. I think it's truly the only way you make a complete organ today, because the cost of pipes is so extravagant, many builders being at $30,000, maybe even $35,000 per stop is almost unaffordable. But most of us that are organists themselves like to have an instrument that's complete, and I like having multiple celestes and multiple solo stops and enough to accompany a big choir or even a single soloist. And that's what a hybrid organ can do. Pipe Integration Manager is a little box. It's obviously a computer, and a pretty high-tech one at that. It has wires that connect to the console that read out what the console is doing, and then it has wires that go out from there. One of those wires goes to a group of boards that make the pipe valves operate. The other wire goes up to the great division and attaches basically to a pipe to keep the electronic voices constantly in tune with the digital voices. So that's a really big plus. It also, in the case of the pipe manager that's in this organ behind me, will allow me to tell this organ in 10 years to add another 30 ranks of pipes. This organ is always in tune because of a really special design that Rodgers has. I haven't seen this on any other instrument, but there's a little piece of metal that's connected to a circuit board, and it reads out the exact temperature of 4 foot C in the great principle. all the time, constantly sending messages back and forth to the console. So if there were any cold draft that come through here or whatever would happen, some churches have, the pipes right above the balcony and an outside door. Anything like that that were to change the temperature of the pipes would also then not only change the temperature of the pipes, but if there's any MIDI equipment that's also associated with the console, it will change all of those strings and everything else that's associated with the instrument to make it play perfectly in tune constantly. In my estimation right now, probably the most successful and most affordable for most any church that's out there today would be a hybrid instrument. It affords the ability for a church to have a complete organ. And I think that's probably the most important thing of all. We have an owner that had a 10-rank all-pipe organ and got bored with it. And it got bored with it within about 15 years because it just didn't have enough variety. What a hybrid organ does is takes the essential things that you need for worship and augments it with other sounds that will actually be soft that are needed for maybe funerals, and loud trumpets that one could hardly afford, although they are here, to make a complete instrument that's designed from the ground up to play everything that you need in today's worship services.
It is just ethereal, just the feeling you get from the sound is like nothing you've ever heard before.
For me, it's personally helping me to worship our Lord a lot better, a lot more focus, and just giving me a beautiful experience in the Mass.
The organ helps bring the service to really what we Catholics believe rooted in Scripture, and helps bring it alive, and help bring the Word alive through our singing and through our prayer.
It's wonderful. It brings you back home. When I'm away and I come back, it just gives you a sense of home when you do hear the organ. It's beautiful.
I love the sound of this instrument. So this organ probably could be considered about as perfect as you can get in a hybrid instrument. It not only completes the vision of this room, which is stunning in itself, but it adds beauty to the room and also adds a sound in here that will allow a lot of people to sing their praises to God.